young Droopy dog, Mother Hubbard's favorite dog.
Droopy! Oh, Droopy dog!
Now she wants me to come in for my daily bone treats. Isn't she sweet?
I'll go to the cupboard to fetch it for you.
Come in, Mother Hubbard.
My heavens, the cupboard is bare, except for this note.
I'd better check it for clues. Sweet Mother Hubbard. Just as I suspected, our prime suspect is Slick Wolf.
Amazing, Droopy. How did you guess?
It says, very truly yours, Slick Wolf. I will apprehend the scoundrel before the little boy Boo blows his horn. Do my eyes deceive me, or is that little red riding hood ahead? Hello, Red. How are things?
Hi, Droopy. I gotta run this takeout order over to Grandma's pad. Trouble is, my new shoes are killing me.
Can I be of assistance?
I thought you'd never ask.
I'll just take a shortcut through the woods.
With a tasty lunch to cheer you up.
Oh, how dear of you, sweet little Droopy.
Thanks for the free meal, sucker.
Uh-oh, looks like I'm on to a clue. Oh, Slick, I think I should warn you about one little thing.
Yeah? What is it?
That basket you stole is filled with seafood.
I love seafood.
Live seafood, that is. Once again, all is peaceful in storybook land. Uh-oh, what's this? A damsel in distress? Why, it's little Miss Goldilocks. You look like you have a problem, Goldie.
I call that a problem.
Careful, it may contain a clue. Just as I suspected.
What already?
See? Large thumbprints in porridge.
Those are mine. Read it already. Have porridge waiting around. Fine, Slick Wolf. Then what the poor Goldilocks to do? I'm fresh out of porridge.
Quick, inside and lock the door. We'll think of something.
I've come for the porridge.
Uh-oh. The three bears aren't here, and there isn't any more porridge, Slick. Care to come in and look around for yourself?
It won't do you any good. The three bears moved down, but they sublet the place to three gorillas.
This is really rich. Three gorillas.
No need to lie to defend me, kind Goldilocks.
So who's lying? They should be home any second now.
Three gorillas. Gonna be home any second now. That's rich. Stop you.
So what can I do for you, Droopy?
Your friendship is enough, my dear.
You know, you're kind of neat. A little droopy, but kind of neat.
like the book says, folks, everyone lived happily ever after.
Pleasure.
I've been taught to be very nice to grandmothers.
Oh, boy, he really is a sucker. We forgot to tell you the pendant has special power to bring wealth.
Well, it certainly does. I got twice my money back.
We got it. We're going to be rich. Rich! The magic pendant.
The only one of its kind.
Get your magic one-of-a-kind pendant here. One-of-a-kind? Magic. We'll pay double for it.
I hope they learn their lesson. I always say... Oh, dear, I forgot what I always say. Now I remember. I always say, look before you bleep. Oh, my. A loose pumpernickel. Up we go. I like your outfit.
Go make the Danish. I'll watch your cake.
Right-o, Spike. Gee, thanks.
The poor dope hasn't got a chance. Gee, poor Droopy's cake just fell. Ready for my decorating job, Droop?
I was going to do it for you, Spike.
Well, cut it out.
If Spike says to cut it out, I cut it out. There, it's all cut out. Spike must be planning some special surprise to go inside the cake for the lovely damsel. Oops.
Wonder where the little jerk disappeared to. Oh well, better get the winning cake finished. Wait till the boss sees Droopy's cake.
Looks like you two have been busy. Wow, what a beauty, Spike. And this would be Droopy's attempt. I don't blame him for hiding his face. Get that lovely cake right over to Farrah's house. And congratulations.
Yes, sir. I can't believe it. I'm going to meet my dream girl. Oh, with this cake, she's a cinch to fall for me.
Oh, my, for me? How thoughtful. Now I have something for you.
But I...
What a lovely cake. Now who can I get to share it with me?
May I volunteer?
What a lovely surprise. Of course you may.
You know something? I'm happy, and I owe it all to my very best friend, Spike.
In the annals of courage and dependability, there are none so brave and bold as the trusty St. Bernard dogs, who for centuries have come to the aid of stranded travelers in the Swiss Alps. This is where they train the rescue dogs. Few can complete this demanding course, but anyone can apply.
I hope this is the right place.
And we do mean anyone.
Pardon me, chum. Can you spare a dime?
Oh, certainly, poor soul.
Wow! Look at that! I mean, isn't that a lot of money to carry around with you?
I've brought all of my life savings to enroll in this school for rescue dogs. Here's your dime, sir.
Oh, then you're one of the new trainees. How fortunate that we should chance to meet.
Do you work here?
Work here? Why, I run the joint. The training facility. In fact, since you're such a bright young fella, I'm going to personally supervise your program. At no extra charge, of course.
Don't we go in there?
Oh, that's just the officers. I can tell you want to get right to the training. See the baby goat way up on top of that mountain? Rescue that baby goat and bring him back here. That's the last we'll see of him.
What next?
What? Give me that. This is gonna be tougher than I figured. This next exercise is to see if you can forage for food in the wild. Sit here in this chair and catch as many fish as you can.
Thank you.
find people who were lost. You see that mountain? I'm going to go hide on that mountain. You hide your eyes and count to 10, and then go over there and try to find me, okay? Get set, go!
1, 2, 3... Hard-nosed. Spike. Oops, here comes the boss. Hi, boss.
So, still standing around like a statue with all this work to do. What have you got to say about this? Some excuse. Quit your stalling and get back to work. So, now you're lying down on a job. Okay, it's quitting time. You two better shape up tomorrow.
Get some sleep. Big day on the job tomorrow. On the job, I guess. I got a hard day's weary.
Never mind about Spike. I'll deal with him when and if he ever shows his face around